Mash up the speaker box.
Promoter watch me and say
she don't want me inside she vet.
A club owner she watch me and say
she don't want me inside she vet.
Cause every time I reach in the dance and I hold on the woman and I start to prance, hey. I lean in on all the bumps, I only mashing up speaker when I start to walk,
hey. When them girls start whining up, I mashing up all the bumps. When them girls start walking up, I lean in on all the bumps. When them girls start whining up, I mashing up all the bumps.
Well, I want to find out also, working with Charles and forming this brand, even though you all work on your own, you still do your personal stuff, but you created a brand as well, yeah, together. Where that came from, as you said, it's 19 years.
Yeah, the friendship but has always
just,
been...
Is it that it just happened?
The friendship has always been there, and I'm one always believe that strength is in numbers. Mm-hmm. You understand? If you check it out, that no war is won by one man. You understand? And I'm one that believe in team. Back in 2000, and it would have been 2010, when Charles and myself decided to do the whole, actually 2009 going into 10, when we decided to do, when I did Speaker Box, I had a relationship with GBM from years before. And when the songs came on the table, and I suggested, I said, listen, how about I call him my boy Charles? And we do with Sean, they couldn't understand. What I was trying to sell them at the time is that because of where I saw our career going, because at that time we were heavily on television, both Sean and myself, and people, it was like you were getting to that top now. I kind of was outgrowing Superstar. Sean was kind of phasing out of the whole Friday Night Live kind of vibe.
Right.
And we wanted to focus more on the craft. As two individuals, bandless, managementless, you understand? It's very hard to really conquer. So we decided, okay, if we come together and pool it, pool both resources, meaning he brings what he brings to the table and I bring what I bring to the table, maybe people might see it and smile, some mightn't, some right, might see it and turn up their face, but we
something
might
fresh and something new
we
too
might actually spark. And we tried it with Speaker Box and Motorbike on two songs, and that's the first time we actually people actually heard that a rhythm only had two songs. And with myself and Charles, and we did that, and it worked, and people started to accept the show of TC and Charles. Charles to himself is a brand, and I'm a brand unto
Jiga
myself, right? Jiga now, but back then it was TC, you know. So with that, we started to develop, and as we started to go on and on, a lot of things started opening up even overseas. Like for instance, we host a show with Dr. J called Foam Fep, and who would have ever thought that Charles and Jiga will headline a show in Toronto and get over 3,000 people singing soca? And we started to realize, yo, this thing could make sense. So we continue doing it, and now moving into 2014 is kind of a blessing, where when we did the radio thing, a lot of people speculated and was like, yo, I do think that was a good move. But we went onto radio at a point in time when, okay, the performance thing was doing so well, and Charles was in a position where his show and lose a couple numbers, and it's like any other thing, it's business.
Yes.
And
so it's says, right move.
So said, so done was the right move. With the immediate connection and the marriage of that where radio is concerned, we went from losing numbers to gaining numbers, and
I mean,
now
number one.
Currently number one drive time in the afternoon.
So yeah,
it makes sense. So it's a matter of now just nurturing the current fan base and developing a new one.
Nice.
And that's the most you can do. As I said, it makes no sense. People focus on negativity now. Focus on what you're doing. Think about
positive,
what you want to do, and let's keep striving.
Now,
you know?
It's time to put you on the spot. Are you ready to be put on the spot?
Yeah.
I know you don't hold water in your mouth, so that's good. Now, people always, when they see, well, Jiga now, and they see this loud personality and confident man, they take it as you being either cocky or arrogant or pompous. But little do they know, when you get to know Jiga, he's a clown and is a very humble person. Why you think people always putting you in that category and always, as you say, throwing a little hate towards you?
It's simple, you know. Perception is a man's reality, and what people perceive, you really can't convince them otherwise unless maybe they get to know the inner you. And you have to understand, I'm very sheltered in my personal life, meaning the government part of my life, the Terran calendar part of my life is very separate from Jiga. You understand? Because I'm very strong when it comes to family. I believe my family, I'm all into that. My family is always first. So when I selling the image of? And you have to understand something. What people need to understand most and foremost, first and foremost, this right here, showbiz television, that's what it is. It's show business. This is not like business or help everybody business. It is show business. There's some things, the most loved people are hated by some. Oprah Winfrey is deemed one of, is a humanitarian, a philanthropist. People love her. But there are sections that you will hate Oprah. And that's just something she just have to accept.
I mean, you keep it
so,
real.
With me, I look at it the same way. I have a core of people who accept what I do, respect what I do, and I do it. And for those who can't understand it, I just hope and pray that one day they will see it for what it is, because I mean no harm or no ill will towards anybody. I've done all what I've done over the years. I have tried and build my name as clean as I could. You understand? If it's one thing you could honestly say, people could say all kind of bad rumors, but what counts to me, black and white, is I'm a young black man that has never been incarcerated, never been held up on no kind of wrong charge,
yes,
or no off, nothing.
Yes, exactly.
You understand? So, but on paper, I'm considered to me a straight up dude.
Mm-hmm.
Your personal feelings towards me might be a little tainted because of a stare or a look, which is what happens all the time, because I hear it all the time. Like, I will be out and people will be like, oh, he don't have any eating up his nose. It's not matter anything up my nose. It's time and place. At the end of the day, I can't really see strangers and be like overly happy. The next thing they will say, so what happened? So I'm he glad or he want to see you, he pushes. You understand? So
yeah,
it's always trying to find that balance. So for those who find that I'm overly cocky, I don't think so, but I hear it all the time. I'm cocky, I'm conceited, this and that. I know the key word now, black and feline something. At the end of the day, I'm a black individual who understands and respects the fact that I'm black and
yes,
happy and very happy in my skin being black and have no problems with that. And all I have to say and all I have to share, as I tell everybody, is for us to just focus on loving more and hating less. And just wake up tomorrow morning and ask yourself, somebody who doesn't talk to at all, like that's not on, just try telling them good morning and see what a difference that can make. Because we see people in our day-to-day lives and just naturally don't have a thing for them and would not say anything. But from the moment you tell that person hi and they answer you and a conversation starts,
something
you realize how the entire 5 years that you waste hating them or not being in them could have been totally different.
I like that.
Yes,
so before we go, tell our viewers something that we don't know about TC. I should say, correct myself, Jaiga.
Something that you don't know about.
In showbiz.
Jaiga. On the showbiz side or on the personal side?
We can do both, if you don't mind.
On the showbiz side, I still play with my fingers every time I'm public.
Why?
Like, I don't know, it's like it's a mechanism. I count people in my mind. It's strange,
it's strange.
Like, alright, like, for instance, I'm always good live. People think I'm good live. Like,
okay,
if I'm hosting an event and it's 15, 20,000 people, I go there and I can open my mouth and I don't look nervous and I don't look scared. But if you ever look at me close, you'll always find a portion of the time when I now start, I'll put my hands in my pocket. When I put my hands in my pocket, I'm actually playing with my fingers. That's something that I do to kind of calm myself, to come in and be like, hey, what's the scene? Hey, what, yeah, yeah, and suddenly, and then the loudness has come down.
So on the personal side,
I love home. And my people feel that, because I love, my biggest vice is Torrance. That's what I live for. I will physically, this will be a wrong word, I don't want to say, because I might have impressionable kids out there, but I don't think I could function without Wi-Fi. I will just commit suicide. I have to have Wi-Fi, and my personal friends know, and I could tell you this, and they could even ask around. Like, I were, for instance, if you don't have Wi-Fi by your place, I don't visit you. If you don't have Wi-Fi, we can't be friends. Straight up, you must have it. Because if you don't have it, I find when I reach by you, if
you
it so happened that in the midst of the lineman thing, I remember it has something me and C, like one of my shoes that is watch like a walk in there or something, and I want to catch it quick, and you win
and
a Wi-Fi,
yeah,
I can't
line
it. I go on later, my brother. I can't line.
Oh gosh, well, Jaiga, it was a pleasure.
No problem.
Thank
anytime.
You so much for blessing the buzz. And you heard from Jaiga first everything that you need to know. If you didn't know, now you need to know what's going on with Jaiga. You heard it here first.
And wait, is the buh?
The buzz.
Buzz.
Buzz. The buzz.
Just watch me now. Watch me now. Watch my
Let me tell you about this girl. She come out to put man inside at the hospital.
The Buzz is being brought to you by Be Mobile. Imagine next.